buddy. This is a binaural microphone test video. I recently purchased a binaural microphone, so now I have full stereo sound, which is a lot nicer than the mono shotgun mic I used in my first video, which was a holdover I found in a closet somewhere. So for this video, I'm going to demonstrate a couple triggers from various objects I have over to my right, and I'm going to be testing them. I just have the microphones just off camera here, laying on the surface, which is just the exposed bare surface of my memory foam mattress topper, which sounds very nice. This microphone I got from the Sound Professionals, and this microphone was recommended by Maria, Gentle Whispering. About 8 or 9 months ago, she made a video in her ASMR Pro Tip series, and she mentioned that this was the very first binaural microphone she ever bought back in, I believe, 2011 or 2012, so if you want to hear what retro ASMR sounds like, then this is it right here. The recorder I'm using is just some, like, low-range Sony voice recorder I got a few years ago when I did some, like, fledgling independent journalism stuff I had a website for, but that's a different story. So, for the first trigger, let's use the packaging that this Sound Professionals microphone came in. It's got some nice plastic sounds. Nice piece of Velcro that makes some interesting sounds too. Now you're probably asking or wondering to yourself, microphone test videos go out of style like 6 or 5 years ago, and you would be right, mostly because it seems like today the bar for entry into ASMR is quite a bit higher than it used to be. It seems like, not that it's, you know, the rule, but it seems like if you want to get started in ASMR these days, it's like you need a soundproof studio, like, from the beginning, which, I mean, you know, if your goal is to compete with the other ASMR channels, then I suppose that's true, but I don't know, to me that kind of goes against the spirit of ASMR, which, especially back at the beginning, was very, it's very community-oriented, it's very collaborative, it was really just a bunch of strange, introverted people who discovered a fascinating phenomenon, and they just shared it with each other. I mean, you know, it's been quite a few years since that's been the case, but, you know, I think videos like this are important because it's, I think it's very important to, maybe not stick to, but always remember the roots of ASMR and, you know, where it all came from. So, I'll probably do a separate video on history of ASMR. I know, I think someone said ASMRtica did a video about it, but I'd like to do my own because I want to. You know, it doesn't really matter what someone else is doing because this is a fun hobby for me, and I've decided that I'm going to make any kind of video that I want to make and just have fun with it, and hopefully you guys too. So, second trigger is going to be the classic blue nitrile gloves. This comes in a big old pack of 10. So, this is a classic staple on a lot of ASMR channels. And no Dr. Roleplay would be complete without them. So, right now it's a little after 4 a.m. because, unfortunately, that is the only time when the traffic is quiet enough and my roommate has usually gone to sleep, so I can film this without I like it when they open. That's a fun sound. I'll leave these gloves on for a little bit. So, next trigger is, could be some coins. Ooh, that's nice. You rub them like that. Produces a very nice sound. And a very nice funny pun, if you want to think about it. Rubbing coins. There's some kind of joke in there, but I'm not sure. Edges of these American quarters are rimmed, or ridged, I should say. Sound. next up is some... I thought I had bubble wrap, but I think I might have thrown that away. Wait a minute, no I didn't. And we're back. The magic of editing. It's almost like I wasn't even gone. So this is the bubble wrap the microphone got shipped in. I mentioned it previously, but I got this microphone by recommendation from Rhea, Gentle Whispering. But it's kind of funny because, you know, I went to the Amazon page to buy this thing, and it's only about $70, which isn't that bad. And there's only 3 ratings for it, which I found, I guess, kind of interesting, because you'd think, like, the budget, affordable-level microphone that Maria would recommend. One of the biggest ASM artists. One of the biggest real ASM artists. I'm going to make a stand and say that. There's other channels that are bigger than her that I don't consider real ASMR, but that's just me. And, you'd think someone like her recommending the microphone, you'd see more people buying it. So, I don't know. Maybe I'm one of the very few people that actually watched that video with the intent of learning equipment for ASMR, but who knows. So, let's get that out of the way. Let's do some keys. This is my keychain. House keys, mail key, motorcycle key, bike lock, knife. Don't be scared by the knife. You know, I've always liked the sound of jingling keys because when I was a really little kid, turned 4 and 7 or so, I remember I used to go to shopping with my mom and my sister, and sometimes I would get lost in a daydream or spend too long looking at some magazine, and I would get lost. And, remember, I would always find my mom again by listening to the sound of jingling keys, because she always had her keys on the outside of her purse, so whenever she walked, there was always that jingling sound. So for me, this is a nice comforting sound. It reminds me of my childhood. This knife actually makes good sound, believe it or not. Almost sounds like I'm shaving. Next up, I have a bottle of water. I really like the sounds of bottled water swishing. This is one of my favorite sounds because I do a lot of writing, especially as a kid when I would write stories during quiet time or during recess. I always like the sounds of paper and pencil. Here's a mechanical pencil. Nice little sound there. So, this is one of my favorites that I discovered while doing some testing for this video. This is the lint roller. This sounds really fun. That drive-by effect. I do have it. Is a common comb. So I've heard very, very few ASMR videos ever feature one of these, which is surprising to me, especially for haircut roleplays, because these sound absolutely fantastic. Lovely sound, and I found an interesting combination. When you combine it with a geode rock, you get a nice crispy version of it. To look at too. Next up is a calculator. one more trigger that I forgot I have on my desk over there, so one more cut. Absolutely magic. It's as if I never left. So, this is a fun one. This is a audiobook CD collection of The Hobbit. Birthday back in August, and I haven't listened to it yet, unfortunately, but I've read the book a couple times, so probably when I start to not remember the book, I'll listen to this for my third read-through. But this has a lot of nice sounds, though. CDs. These aren't the main attraction. It's the two halves. Also put these over the microphones. That's all the time we have for today, because for whatever reason my camera can only record half an hour at a time, even though it has 16 gigabytes of memory, but I'll get that solved eventually. So thank you for watching, and hope you've enjoyed it. If you have finished it, let me know in the comments which triggers you liked, which triggers you didn't like, and I will be sure to take that into account when I make future videos, because I'd like to know what sounds good for you, because I know it sounds good for me, but it'd be interesting to see what sort of preferences everybody has, and to, you know, talk about what triggers are good, what triggers are bad, and maybe even add what triggers you would like to see in future videos. So, also, when I eventually get a stand for these mics, I will incorporate sensitive, you would hear overwhelming white noise. So once I get that sorted out,